Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install MySQL Server with MySQL Workbench in Windows. So let's get started. So just go to Google and type MySQL. You'll be getting the first link as mysql.com. Just click this, and in this website here you'll be having this download option. Just click on that, and in the downloads you need to just scroll down, and here you'll be having this MySQL community GPL downloads. Just click that, and here we will be having so many MySQL things, but we need to go for MySQL installer for Windows. Alright, so here also we will be having Workbench. Please don't click that, you need to click MySQL installer for Windows. Select that, and you will be having this MySQL installer 8.0.34, which is the latest version, and just select Microsoft Windows. And if you scroll down, here you will be having a web community one, and you will be having the installer community. So you need to install the MySQL installer community and not the web one. Just click on the download, and you need to click on this no thanks, just start my download. Yeah, so the download has begun. It's about 331 MB in size, so just be patient till then. So once the download is complete, just click on open. So you will be getting this MySQL installer type thing, and by default you will be having this server only option enabled. Alright, so you need to click on custom. Alright, and you need to click on next, and here we will be having the list of products that are offered by MySQL. So I'll just click on this plus icon nearby MySQL servers, and here you will be having this MySQL server. Click on the plus again, and click on the plus again in MySQL Server 8.0, and you need to just select this thing. Okay, MySQL Server 8.0.34, it needs to get highlighted in blue, and you need to click on this green color arrow. So once you do this, you'll be getting that name over here, which means that this particular product or software is going to get installed on your system. Alright, this is a standard thing, don't ignore this. Okay, next thing, we need to go into applications, and here we will be having the most important thing, which is MySQL Workbench, which is like a GUI tool for MySQL. It's super important. Alright, same thing, just click the plus icon, click that blue color enabled, and click the green color right arrow. You will be getting there, and I think MySQL shell is also important. Same thing, click that and green color arrow, and you also have MySQL router, which is not most commonly used. I have never touched that thing. And you also have the documentation and examples, which are also not needed. So I think these three are pretty much the standard things that everybody use. So I'm good with this. These three things, please install these three. And just click on next. And you'll be getting the same over here, which is having the status ready to install. And once we click on execute, here it says, right, the installation of these packages will begin. So let me just now click on execute. So here you can see, right, it's installing, and the progress appears over here. So once all the packages are installed, you'll be getting this green color mark, and you'll be having the status as complete. So just click on next, and ready to configure. Yeah, this is fine. Just click on next, and here you'll be having the port and the development computer. So just don't touch this stuff. Okay, just click on next. Use strong password encryption for authentication. Yeah, this is fine. Just click on next, and here you need to be super careful. Okay, you need to enter your MySQL root password. So I would really recommend you to like save this password somewhere. It's really a hard process to reset this, and it may even like require you to uninstall and reinstall your MySQL setup. So I would basically, you know, have a familiar password. That's the thing. So I'll just enter my familiar password over here, or you can just have it somewhere else. So yeah, we can, it says weak, I don't care. I will just click on next, and yeah, standard account, this is fine. Service name, everything is fine. Just click on next. Yeah, grant full permission for the user. Yeah, this is also fine. I'll just click on next, and these are the steps that are going to take place now. I will just click on execute, and our installation will begin now. After some time, you will be getting the configuration for MySQL Server was successful. Click finish to continue. I'll just click on finish. Yeah, I'll just click next again. So here you will be having two options: start MySQL Workbench after setup, start MySQL shell after setup. I'll just click on finish and I'll just enable these two to make sure that they are installed properly. So I'll just click on finish. So this is the MySQL shell over here and this is MySQL Workbench. So first let us finish off MySQL Workbench, then later we will go to MySQL shell. Alright, so first thing what you need to do is you need to just go to services and you need to click on open, and in the services you need to have this thing, MySQL 80. Yeah, so this needs to be running and I would recommend you to set it up as automatic. So in the properties you need to have this as startup type as automatic. So if you don't have it automatic, you need to like every time go here, turn it on manually. So I would recommend you to have this as automatic startup type. So we just select this and click on automatic. Yeah, so this is running now, so this is fine. So now let's go to our MySQL Workbench and you need to click on this plus thing and here you'll be having this connection name. So I'll just type my first connection, something like that, and you need to just click on OK. That's it, you'll be having the connection over here. Just double click it and here you need to enter the password that you gave during your MySQL setup. So I'll just enter that password and I'll just click on OK. So this will take me in and here I can run any MySQL query. So let me just now first go and create a database and make sure that the command is working fine. So let me just go and type create database. I will just go with the name, new name. This is going to be the name of my database, something. I'll just run it. So I'm getting here a green mark, which means that this query has been executed successfully. So I'll just go with something, show databases. Yeah, this is the command to display the list of databases. So we will be getting these things and I know what you are thinking, the font size is very small. So to increase the font size, what you can do is you need to go to edit and you'll be having the preferences, and inside preferences you'll be having this fonts and colors. The next one to modeling, just click fonts and colors and basically just, you know, change everything to like 30 or 40. Yeah, just change it because I think the size of the fonts throughout MySQL is small, so you know, better change everything to a decent number and just click on OK. Yeah, and it won't get changed, so let me just now close my connection. And if I just now again go into my connection, just enter it. So now you can see the font size has drastically improved a lot. So this is good. Now we're done with our MySQL Workbench setup. So now let's go and do the MySQL shell setup. So if I just now go to my command prompt and if I just now type MySQL hyphen hyphen version, I'll be getting this MySQL is not recognized. Okay, so for that let's fix it now. So let me just now close this and you need to go to the folder where you have installed MySQL. Alright, so by default it's going to be C, program files, and here you'll be having MySQL, and inside that you need to go to MySQL Server 8.0. it's not shell, it's not Workbench, it's server, and inside that you'll be having this bin. Click that and you need to basically just copy this thing, copy it fully. Alright, and in case if you, it's hard for you to find this path, what you can do is you can basically just go and search for MySQL. You'll be getting this MySQL Workbench. Just click on open file location, right click it again, open file location, just go back a folder, you'll be having this MySQL Server 8.0, and inside this bin we will be back to the normal path where we were began. So just copy this path till bin under Server 8.0. after copying it, go to search and type for environment. You'll be getting this option called as edit the system environment variables. Just click on open and in this you'll be having this environment variables thing. Click that and under system variables just click on path and you need to click on edit, and in this you will be having an option called as new. Click that and you need to just paste this path. Be careful, it's MySQL Server 8.0 and till bin. Just click on OK everywhere here also, and in case if you are having your command prompt open, just close and reopen it again, otherwise you won't be getting the changes affected. So I'll just go again to search CMD, I'll just zoom it, and if I type MySQL --version. So here you can see, just a moment ago I was getting some kind of error, but now I'm getting the version, which is the latest version that we have installed right now. So after this, in order for us to run MySQL commands through our terminal, what you can do is, you need to type MySQL -u space root -p. Just hit enter, and here you need to enter the password that you gave installed MySQL server and Workbench. So that's the reason why I told you that password is like super important. Without that password, you cannot do anything here. So just enter that password. And here you can see, now I'm getting this MySQL command prompt thing, like a shell where I can run MySQL queries. So I'll just go with show databases. Just hit enter. So here you can see that I'm having this new name database, which is the database that I created a moment ago. So as I told you, this Workbench is super useful tool. Just a GUI basically, you know, shows the names and rows present in a column in a much more visual and appealing way. So yeah, both have the same data at the end of the day. So that's it guys, this is how you install MySQL Server and MySQL Workbench in Windows, and I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many tutorials in MySQL, C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, Spring Boot, CRUD Operations. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.